collaboration with our brothers in arms, the Americans, has gone on for years, doing operations all over the globe.
We have laid down our lives for the greater good. And in every conflict that we've been in, the Brotherhood comes first.
That's how deep the SF blood runs.
Rising up! Suffer in silence!
In this series, an elite team of ex-Special Forces soldiers.
Keep pushing! Let's go!
From the UK and USA, have combined their skills to create the toughest course yet.
What's the right? The carrier's getting there now! Let's go!
Bringing together the most grueling elements of Special Forces selection.
Come on!
From both sides of the Atlantic.
America's bringing something to the table!
This is a combination of the best fighting forces in the world.
Yes! I'm going to Vegas, baby!
Joining the DS as chief instructor is ex-Recon Marine, Rudy Reyes.
Incoming! Get up, get up!
With 15 years experience fighting in multiple war zones.
I pride myself in being hard to kill. Taliban, Al-Qaeda, Mujahideen.
Bunch of amateurs!
Many have tried to kill me, but I took them down.
Get off your knees! Hurry up!
Also joining the DS is ex-US Navy SEAL, Remy Adelecki.
Go, go, go! Yes!
With over 13 years serving his country.
I want the recruits to learn through pain.
This was your warm-up. Now we're gonna get to the real game.
And believe me, they're gonna learn a lesson through pain.
Let's go, Mountain Goats!
Each recruit must go beyond the physical.
Get the tire!
To come face to face with their true character.
You better not stop again or I'm dropping your ass.
No other test asks as much.
Keep working, keep working. Do not give up.
Or means as much.
Be proud of yourself, mate. Own it. Come on.
Proud of you. Give me something.
Yeah.
To the few who make it through.
Good job, both of you.
Excellent.
Welcome to the slaughterhouse, little lambs.
The second phase of selection.
I can't even bring myself to say, oh, my feet are hurting.
My back's gone, my knee's gone, my arm's sore. Proper.
And of the 20 recruits who began, all 20 remain.
How old are you, Nick, if you don't mind me asking?
How old am I?
Yeah.
40.
Oh, we pick up the old aches and strains, as a little bit older now, wouldn't it?
Just creeps up on you, doesn't it?
Get so disheartened.
That's what I kind of worried about, like, I'm going to be up against some young whippersnappers.
That's it.
Recruits! Out on the parade square!
Let's go.
Parade square. Good to go. All right. Phase two. We started with 20. We still have 20. There's not room for 20 recruits. I expected someone to give up, voluntarily withdraw, so to separate the wheat from the chaff. Pressure is going to be applied, so it's absolutely critical. When you find your mind wandering, get it back to center. That is the only way you're going to continue. Alignment, all right? We're gonna leave this parade square right now, cover down the vehicles. Let's go. Move fast.
To earn the title, Recon Marine, I had to believe that no matter what, I was going to absolutely pass selection.
Let's go! Let's go!
But you can't just believe in yourself, you must believe in your teammates. If you cannot do that, you are useless to a Special Forces team.
Tighten it up!
Before they get to their first task...
Team unity!
The recruits must run in the searing midday heat with 35 pounds in their bergens.
Backpacks off and then sit on them.
I don't want to hear any talking.
In SF, we put our lives in each other's hands over and over again. And that's what each and every single one of you will do today. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Pay attention.
Eyeballs up!
Foxy!
Oh, here we go.
Working in pairs, one will free fall off the top of a 50-foot cliff. At the bottom, their partner must be ready to break their fall.
Hands on head! Stand by! Go!
Break too early, and they risk hitting the cliff. Break too late, and they risk plummeting to the ground.
You trust me?
I trust you.
What?
What I want you to do is get your harnesses on. Do it in a proper way.
Yes, staff.
Go now.
2 minutes, move it!
All right, step to me, number 20. No, fucking hell, I'm not shaking your hand.
Recruit number 20, Leo.
When the person, that body, reaches there, you're gonna break.
Is partnered with Brakeman. Number 15, Nick.
There you go. Think about it, take control now.
I feel like I'm in okay shape for 40 years of age.
There you go.
I just want to know what I'm capable of and who the person is in my head.
Happy 15.
Happy stuff.
Lower yourself down. There you go. Then now lock off. Okay, there's your step. Nice and composed.
Take control. Got it. Now take the tension. Stand by.
Enjoy the ride.
Go! Let it go. You brake when you need to.
Brake!
Got it?
Stop.
You right? Hey, what's up?
Brilliant.
You feel safe? He had control of you?
Yeah, I trusted him.
Yeah. Okay, so overall, that was a fucking good effort.
Thank you,
well
Steph.
Done.
Thanks, Steph.
Disappear over there and chat about it. Go.
Come on, buddy.
Cheers, mate.
That was a good one.
I think I've just nearly lost my rate, bollock. It's a...
No. I'm through here. I think it's right. Oh, fuck, I've done it wrong. Sorry.
Is it right?
Up. Right. I'm through here.
How about you take your helmet off first? I think that'll be helpful.
Yes, Steph.
Not you, you fucking half-wit.
Seven, hurry up!
Krypton factor, you ain't fucking winning, are you?
Nice stuff.
Next up, number 9, Vince. We'll be breaking for number 7, Justin.
I don't mind heights. However, it can sometimes take the kind of wind out of me being too high.
I'm brave, I'm strong, I'm a warrior, I'm a conqueror, I'm brave. Shut up.
I'm learning to, like, not let that voice in my head that says, you're not good at this, to take over.
Justin?
Yeah?
Are you okay?
I don't know.
However, it can be a bit tricky sometimes.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Yeah.
Come on, Riff.
Fuck me. You got roller boots on.
Nice stuff.
Fucking calm down. You're about to take somebody's life in your hands. Calm down.
Yes, stuff.
Seriously, relax.
Feet, that's it. Keep your legs straighter. That's it, go on, let more go. That's it, nice and confident. Now, wait, hold. Oh. It's all right. Yeah. Just chill.
Yeah.
Look at where you're gonna put your feet.
Yeah.
Go on then, do that.
I don't know where.
You do, just like, naturally step your one foot back. That's it, now stand up on that. There you go. And now the next foot.
Yeah.
Right, now you're into the abseil stance. Get that, there we go. Keep the fucking arm there, that's it.
This is the dangerous bit right now. Of all the things that go wrong, it's always this one. So I don't be the fucking person that does it.
Your stuff.
We have control. Hands on your head. Stand by.
Lean back. Enjoy, enjoy.
Go! Break, break!
How do you feel there? How was that?
Scary stuff.
You recovered well?
Yes, stuff.
So overall it worked. A few things you need to iron out there between the two of you.
Yes, stuff.
All right? Go and change your underpants. Away you go.
Come on.
Come on, man. Oh, come on, come on. You all right?
Well done. Thank you. Well done, really well done.
Thank you for having me.
Rope work is very serious.
Okay, how come you got paired with him? 7 foot taller than you and about 20 stone heavier.
I'd much rather be at the top, staff.
You might well fucking be if you get this wrong.
If you miss a turn, it could be fatal.
Well, now step down.
This is not a sport, this is not a game. This is life and death.
Let's go! Hands off! Hands off! Break, 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 break!
Do anything wrong,
staff.
Relax.
Staff.
It's a massive responsibility having another operator's life in your hands.
Here we go.
Come on, come on, come on. Break,
break, break, break!
They absolutely must believe in themselves.
Calm down, calm down.
The shock and awe that we rain down on the recruits, it's for a reason.
You did it.
To get them into a combat stress headspace so that we can see their character.
You look like the bottle of milk. Why are you so white?
I'm scary.
Well done.
Thank you. Saved my life.
You're welcome.
You all right?
Yeah. Oh, staff.
Next! I hear you. Relax.
Good news, staff.
You all right?
Yeah.
How are you feeling?
Yeah, confident, mate.
I ain't your fucking mate.
Sorry, staff.
You will be sorry. You know why you call him a mate? Because you're shitting your pants. You're not fucking relaxed. You're not thinking.
Next to break is one of the youngest recruits on the course. Number 2, Dylan. Partnered with number 13, Sarah.
Clasping your hands together and lean. Clasping your hands together. That.
I definitely say I'm a people pleaser. The vibe you get of being liked than disliked is such a better feeling.
Relax, go on. Come closer.
Yeah.
Hands together. Lock your fucking hands. Fuck's sake. I'm going to take you off this in a minute.
Yes. I will always do my best. If I'm not good at something, I'll try and try and try.
Take a breath. Take a fucking deep breath now. You need to calm down. You are about to take somebody's fucking life in your hand. Relax. You're like a hyperactive cat on steroids.
I feel like I'm ready, staff.
You ready? So the person is falling. You're looking for a point to break. You have to let them fucking run. Don't panic, because you'll fuck them up. If we're doing this and banging into the side of the rocks. Hands on your head! Stand by! Go! Let go of the roof! No!
Oh, my God.
Ow. Fucking broke too early. And that's why she's starting to go upside down. Then you let it go, and then you just went into ratchet. I had to fucking grab the rope. Let it run through, gently. Get your hands high. Calm down! Calm down!
Yes, staff.
That could have been a disaster. She'd have probably broke her fucking neck. Take a breath.
Hard for me, I swear.
Sorry?
It was hard for me, that.
Come here.
Taking someone else's life.
All right, listen. This is what we're building up to. Everything you're going to do now, you're going to have people's lives in your hand. Do you understand that?
Yes, staff.
Get that into your head. That could have gone fucking badly wrong, couldn't it? You need to get a grip of your fucking emotions, okay? Go away together, get over there and fucking sort it out, talk together. Go, disappear, disappear, disappear.
Oh, sorry.
We're fine, we're fine.
Fuck.
Are you in together, yeah?
Yeah, Mum.
All right, you're all right, come on, move up.
We're good. I'm here, you're good, we're good. We're good.
Number 2, shake it off. If you want to redeem yourself, take control.
Still got 10 more days on this course. Just keep going, all right?
Your stuff.
We understood?
Your stuff.
Good to go.
Put on your Bergens, get ready to move out.
Fucking idiot, man. I totally lost my shit.
Just completely fucked my head up.
Yeah, have a look at there, mate.
Hallucinating last night. I thought there was a snake underneath my bed. I was like, what the fuck was that?
It was just Reese's cock.
Yeah.
Coming to Greece.
Coming out, isn't it? He's alive, he's back.
There's a cobra.
I feel fucking dumb, mate. But it is what it is, isn't it? You're not going to be good at everything, are you?
You know, there were a couple surprises. Number two. I think he's got a lot of talent. His attitude for putting out is very good, but he's too nervous. He looked like he was about to break down. I saw him, and in a complete soup sandwich.
I showed him how to do a diamond grip.
Yep.
And he was like this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He could not calm down, mate. It was a clusterfuck.
He has some type of underlying issue. He has something going on.
So far we've got number two.
Yeah.
Anybody else?
Nobody's really paying attention. All you gotta do is just beast them a little bit.
Shake out the deadwood now.
Is everybody checking each other's bags?
Yeah.
Make sure you do, even if you think your bag's right, check each other's bags. Double check. Yep.
Everybody out, working kit on the parade square.
Shoelaces done up.
Water bottles.
Cool.
Common sense also as well, guys.
Number two, get your head up and your hands to your side. Stop fidgeting around. Get your head up, number two. What the fuck did I just say? You know what? Screw it. Everybody, because the number two bear crawled to the gate. Now.
I can't see.
Let's go! Tighten it up! Tighten it up!
So the reason why we apply pressure is because we want the recruits to understand within here...
Get in the vehicle! There we go.
...that their preconceived limits are incorrect. There is so much more within you. You just have to believe it.
You know what? I've had no sleep and just a lapse of concentration. All I do is swat a fucking fly.
And you just have to keep pushing, even when you feel you can't push anymore. When you feel you can't push anymore, push some more.
The recruits have been taken 3 miles west of base to an area known as Eshakria.
Right, ditch your Bergens. Right, about turn. Leopard crawl to the next DS. Go! You start dropping back, we're going to start taking your numbers because I'm sick to death of you loafing, thinking you're on fucking holiday.
The DS will beast the recruits in the desert, weeding out the weakest and forcing them to quit.
Air crawls! Off your knees!
They must race to a series of RV points, changing exercise at each DS.
Asses down!
It won't stop until one recruit hands in their armband.
My unit, Recon Battalion, led the invasion to Iraq.
Let's go, 17!
We fought for almost a month straight, day and night.
Bunny hop, let's go, you can do it! Ass in the sand, let's work!
Fighting in 130-degree heat with a freaking chemical suit on.
I want you walking like this the whole time! Now, down!
Moving through sand, it is so hard. It feels like every step sapping your strength.
Let's go!
It all starts here.
3 and 5, bunny hop! Get your asses down!
Self-belief. It's the only way to prepare the mind, body, and spirit for the bone-numbing fatigue of combat operations.
Crawl! Milestone! 11 on your back! Crab crawl!
Falling behind is number 11, JJ.
What are you doing, 7?
And number 7, Justin.
7, give me your band. You done?
No, sir.
Then go!
Growing up, it was pretty tough. Being many different things, being black, being gay, being a Christian.
Cast out! Keep going!
It's made me build like a tougher exterior and like a tough skin.
Duck walk from here. Your knees do not touch the deck. Put your back, what the fuck are you doing? Go back and duck walk right.
My brother and my dad, they were both ex-Marines and, you know, tough and all that. When I told them about being on the course, where they was like, what are you getting yourself into?
This is not summer camp. It's not Disneyland. You signed up for a selection course. It's called putting the fuck out.
What?
Number 15, Nick, is pushing up through the middle of the pack.
I remember back as a teenager going through puberty. I was a very angry person, angry at the world and angry at the hand I'd been dealt.
Move yourself!
Hated what used to stare back at me in the mirror. That's when I started hitting the gym. If I wasn't hurting the next day, I hadn't trained enough.
The recruits have been beasted for over an hour.
Pays to be a winner!
What are you fucking doing? What the fuck are you doing? Right, fuck off over there.
I think if I have the VW, in that moment, I think I'll probably be relieved of all the pain. But I think I was real proud of knowing that I played the good fight and I played by the book and I gave my all.
Take what you learn and apply it in your life. I don't want you to feel bad. I don't want you to feel miserable. You understand that?
Number 7, Justin, is the first recruit to leave the course, bringing the task to an end. 19 recruits remain.
You think you can pull the wool over our eyes? You think you can bullshit us? You think because you're not going to give in your armband that we don't notice it? We know who you are. We know who's digging out and we know who isn't. And you know as well. Fucking disgraceful.
Why do it? Why put deodorant on over like umpteen amounts of layers of sweat?
I live in hope.
Of the 20 recruits who began the course, 19 remain.
Well, gents.
He's fucking, I'm telling you.
Mission accomplished, first one.
Pop my cherry.
I popped it for you.
Oh, thank you, thank you.
Well, don't worry, mate, they'll come thick and fast soon, trust me.
They're coming, mate.
Roger. All right, let's hang it up.
Is your hands all right?
Completely.
Yeah, it's not good, is it? What did you do it on, what challenge?
It's been playing up before I sort of come in here. And I've got it under, I've got all the swelling down, and it's just... Cos, look, I'm pressing... When I'm pressing down on that, that's when it happened. What can we do?
Take it easy. Take it easy.
So, how are you?
I'm in a lot of pain here with this.
Are you?
Nursing an old boxing injury, number 11, JJ, visits Chief Medical Officer, Salia.
It could be a small fracture. You're going to need an X-ray, and so that means that I am medically withdrawing you.
That's it. Once if I get an X-ray, I can't come back on, obviously.
Concerned that a fractured hand could be permanently damaged if he were to continue, the DS have no option but to medically withdraw him from the course.
good on you for, you know, still pushing through the pain and trying your best. Allow this to be something that is a launching pad.
Yeah.
Into the next chapter.
It's been a positive thing for me, definitely.
Yeah.
Well
cheers,
done.
Buddy. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Be strong. Do the right thing, all right?
Cheers.
Number 11, JJ, is the second recruit to leave. Now, just 18 remain.
So, Foxy, you do the honors?
Yeah.
We lost another recruit. All right. Second phase, day 4. What did y'all see? What y'all think?
My positives today is 15. It was very good. Strong unit.
I was really impressed with him.
He wasn't at the front, but he was putting in 110%. I'll give him that.
Yeah. Number 2. Brakeman. Test.
He hadn't got a clue where he was going, what was going on. He was shitting himself.
Yeah, he puts too much pressure on himself.
He is enthusiastic. He's emotionally gassed, isn't he?
Yeah, he is.
That emotion is just draining him.
All right, let's bring him in.
Yeah.
Sound good?
Yeah.
Good to go.
Yeah.
All right.
Number 2!
In trouble, Anna.
Fucking
hell. Here we fucking go.
Let's go!
Come on, over here.
These last 3 days?
I think I've performed to the best of my capability stuff.
How did you feel during the break and fall task?
I suffered with a lot of anxiety and I lost it under pressure stuff today. I thought, she's got a family. What if I fuck up now? And I just completely couldn't stop getting that out of my head. She's alive, but fucked up big time.
You didn't fuck up. You just let the situation get the better of you. I mean, you were worried about something that didn't happen, and you were worrying about something that hadn't happened.
I know what family means to people. Family's a massive part, isn't it, of people's lives?
You got a great relationship with your parents?
Obviously, I do with my dad, but four years ago, so it was my little sister and my mum. It was on the 22nd of May. They just went out to an Ariana Grande concert, and, next thing, obviously, they all finished and stuff, and a terrorist attack, a bomb went off. Next thing, me and my dad fly up in my little car because he'd had a glass of wine, not knowing what to expect. And my dad's running up to random women in the street, trying to be like, Michelle, is that you? Like, he just completely lost it. And my little sister comes running out. And she's just like, Mum's gone, Mum's gone. I'm like, sure, come on. We'll find her. And unfortunately, my mum got caught in the edge. She was pronounced dead the next day, and that's your new reality. I had to become a man straight away because my dad was a broken man and my sister needed looking after. So I just adopted this persona, this happy, smiling, we can do it, look at our families, and we thrive, stuff we really do.
I have to say that that's honorable. That's strong. You stepped up in the midst of tragedy. Didn't shut down.
Yeah.
You got a lot of potential. It's been noted. Your work rate is good. You got a lot of resilience within you. You got a lot of character. But try and overlay the shit that you've learned
through some shit times and apply them in some of the things that we're going to be throwing at you.
Your stuff. Make sure.
Guard!
I lost my mum. I lost the main part of the key to our family. And I owe her to be the best person I can be. So I'll keep striving for the moon. I'll, you know, keep working hard every day.
Fucking hard, that conversation.
And be a strong person for my family.
It's a weak lift off your shoulders, isn't it? It's nothing to worry about now. You can just crack on and get back to smashing it like you always do.
Exactly, mate.
As always, but I appreciate it. Pony, have you had a dump yet?
Dump is like a too much credit to it, but a little slithering snake came out.
Nice. Thank fuck. 4 days in.
The recruits are nearing the end of phase two, living in a remote forward operating base in the heart of the desert.
So many flies in here. Oh my God. That's grim.
Can you rub my back?
I think you need to get in your crack.
Gimmer. Don't want to sort me out.
But you can reach your own butt crack.
In the last 20 years, we have not been fighting an enemy that wears a uniform. World War II, Korea, even Vietnam. In modern warfare, we're fighting guerrillas that can blend, hide, and deceive within the local population.
Let's go! Tighten it up!
Sometimes you have a fraction of a second to ascertain enemy or friendly.
It's the final task of phase two of selection, and the DS have brought the recruits to a simulated enemy compound. Here they will test who has the self-belief to make life and death decisions in the heat of battle.
When deployed to a combat area of operation, we receive rules of engagement. These are a set of standards. They protect you, they protect your team, and they also protect the civilians that live here. On operations, things come at you very fast. It's life and death. Split second decisions, and you have to make the right decision.
Safety catch, two rounds.
24 hours ago, the recruits were trained in the rules of engagement.
Relax. What you have in your hand is the document that gives you the right to fire the weapon. There's no room for hesitation. We have to decide, is that the terrorist, is that not the terrorist? If you believe you are under threat, shoot to kill.
Faster, let's go!
Heading into the compound is number two, Dylan. The recruits must make their way through the compound.
I'm right on your tail. Which way are we going? Get your hand on that weapon.
To simulate a real battle zone, they will come under fire from the DS and will be expected to shoot back.
Good decision.
They will then face an enemy who will either attack or surrender.
You're left, don't we?
And the recruits must make a decision whether to shoot to kill or hold their fire.
Make a decision when you go forward. Make a decision.
One gun. One gun.
Stop! Relax.
Stop.
Right, listen to me. So you came in here, what did you see? What was going on?
Enemy with a gun pointing at me.
Where?
So I chose to fire.
Okay, no problem. So you came into here?
Somebody came out with a gun, so I chose the decision to shoot straight away.
Do you think that was the right decision?
Yes, because he came at me with a gun, Staff.
You sure about that?
100%
sure he wasn't
Staff.
Just fucking scared?
No, he's got a gun pointed at me, Staff. And he's
you sure about that?
100% staff.
So you're 100% sure you did the right thing?
Yes, staff.
So am I. Well done. You made a good decision.
Thank you,
all
staff.
Right? Good effort. When I say go, disappear up that sandbank there and then off to the right. Go.
Number two, Dylan, successfully completes the task.
Get low, get low.
Lower, lower. Move, move, move.
Get in there now! Move then! The fucking fire in there!
In modern warfare, there's a code of conduct.
Come on, make a decision!
An enemy is fighting you, you fight and you kill them.
Got him! Make a decision!
An enemy that surrenders is no longer a threat. You must treat them with dignity and respect.
Check me through, check me through!
What's going on? Where are we gonna go?
Of all the combat missions I've done, what I'm most proud of is I was taking fire in the middle of night, looking for enemy.
We're going left! We're going left!
Running towards the gunfire.
Let's move!
An old man appears out of the hut with an AK. My machine gunner says, Sergeant Reyes, do I light him up?
Boy, get ready, make a decision! Make a decision! Make a decision!
He can't see us, we're completely invisible. And I'm saying, hold! Hold!
Stoches! Make a decision! Stop!
We do not pull the trigger. A second later, two little girls come running out, running to the old man, holding his legs.
What the fuck just happened? You now had a scenario which is to save somebody. You fucking killed everything that moved. Go and fucking think about that as you run up that hill and disappear.
Run, 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 run. Got him, let's go. Let's go, fast, faster, let's go, let's go.
Still to be tested is number 15, Nick.
Down, you better, get down, you better, crawl in.
What I hope to find out about myself from the course is to find out who I truly am.
Let's go, which way? Come on, what's happening?
A lot of self-doubt.
Keep going forward then, let's go.
I want to see what other people see in me.
Let's go! We're getting shot, come on! Come on, then what's happening? I'm behind!
I just want to know what I'm capable of.
Which way? Which way are we going? Go up that fucking tunnel, let's go, let's move! Let's make a fucking decision! Make a decision!
Stoches!
Stop! So you came in, what did you see, what happened? You saw a person?
I saw a person with a gun, but it wasn't pointing at me.
And that's why you didn't fire?
Yes, staff.
That's a good decision, really, isn't it?
It is, staff.
Then why didn't you make a good decision back there? He was stood there with a rifle. He was shooting at us. Is that a threat or not a threat?
It is, staff, yes.
So why didn't you shoot him? You know what, you're lucky. You were at the fucking front, I was behind you, and I'm fucking dead. You failed it, didn't you?
Yes.
Take that body armor off and put it down there.
All right, Nicky boy. It's fucking rough, innit? Could you not pull the trigger in a way?
No, I don't think I could. Till, like, you're in my job, you just don't buildings. You don't rush in and you do something like that. You risk assess it.
It was always going to be more challenging for you. You know, you save lives, you don't take lives. Do you understand? So, it'd be weird if you didn't mess it up in a way, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because that's what you do.
Of the 18 recruits, only 9 successfully passed the task.
Right. What was the purpose of the exercise? Anybody? Courage of conviction. Some of you just saw red mist and fucking shot anything that moved. Some of you just did fuck all. Learn from it. Get out of my sight. Disappear. Go. Go.
Got it, mate.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, it's on the
table. Is it the whole pressure thing? No.
Yeah, it just doesn't feel natural to me. Going all guns blazing.
Number 15!
Number 15.
15.
pick up the fucking pace. Close the gate behind you. Put your hands on this wall, straight ahead.
After struggling on the last task, number 15 Nick is summoned to see the DS.
I've watched you, 15.
Stop.
You're jacked, strong. I expected a lot more physical performance out of you. I thought you'd be performing better. But that got me thinking, obviously there's other things going on. Performance isn't just physical.
Stop.
Today you had a little wobble, didn't you?
I did, yeah. Just let things get in my head and just that self-doubt.
It's obvious that you have this shield that prevents you from being present, and then that turns into becoming timid. But this is no freaking cakewalk, this is no picnic out here. It's designed that way for a reason.
Where are you at in your head at the moment with this course right now?
I don't know, just being here and being surrounded by a group of people is very challenging for me.
Why do you think that is?
From a very young age, I felt different. I felt a boy trapped in the wrong body. And then that became progressively worse once I started puberty.
Mm.
And it was the fear of growing up with two sisters and knowing what was ahead. I remember being as young as probably 5, 6 years old, I would beat my chest every night and hoping and praying that I'd never wake up with breasts. Eventually, was able to do something about it. And 9 years ago, I went through gender reassignment surgery. And I wish I could have done something about it a lot sooner, or even better, been born correctly. But I'm trying to make the best of the hand that I've been dealt.
What career path have you chosen?
I'm a firefighter.
How long have you been a firefighter?
20 years, now staff.
How long of that were you a female firefighter?
12 years.
That's pretty impressive to think that you've got through that, even after a huge change. Do you know what I'm saying?
I can't change my past. You know, I can rip up photographs of my previous life, but it's still there in my head. I always look at other men and think, you know, I just don't believe in myself. I just don't think I'm there yet.
I think a lot of your disbelief stems from constantly thinking back and looking at stuff that's happened in the past. And presume you're here to prove to yourself that you can move forward.
Very much so, staff.
You can do it.
Yeah, I'm just turned 40 and, you know, it feels like I'm still waiting for my life to begin.
Maybe you were feeling that you were not authentic, but there's nothing fake about what goes on here. The purpose of this is to reveal character. And it seems that you have character because you're a very strong person. I mean, what you've done with your life already is quite amazing, all right? Some of the DS wasn't sure if you'd still be around. I'd like to see you freaking shit can those doubts.
Because you've got a lot more in the tank. And you will get a lot more out of this, but you've got to stick with it.
Stop. Just one day at a time.
Yeah, exactly. Guard!
Thank you, sir.
You're exactly right. He's got a lot more in the tank.
Hands on the wall, please.
stuff.
I didn't even know about the word transgender back then. It was just something that I felt I needed to do. You know, it's a lot of pain and heartache that I've had to go through to be the person that I truly am. But it was worth it in the end. Now I can pass the other men on the street. You know, people say, all right, mate. And it's a nice feeling to know that I've accomplished what I needed to do.
How was today for you?
Good. You have to take a moment to reflect on what you've done.
So my external now matches my internal. And it's a nice feeling.
What an experience.
It's just sort of like a bucket list thing, isn't it? It's that mad, right?
Next time.
On the right! And Gary, you'll get in there now!
Mindset is everything. You must compartmentalize your pain and fear. No! If you do not have that ability, you will not survive.
Do you have what it takes to survive SAS selection? Go to channel4.com/takepart for more information.